வெல்கம் பேக் டு தி எம்ஆர் அகாடமி. இது மாணவர்களுக்கான தளம் மட்டுமல்லாமல் வேலை தேடுபவர்களுக்கான தளமாகவும் மாற்றமடைந்துள்ளது. உங்களுடன் நான் ஜி சக்திகுமார், எம்எஸ்சி பிஎட், பிஜி அசிஸ்டன்ட் இன் கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ். இன் திஸ் வீடியோ வி ஆர் டிஸ்கஸிங் அபவுட் தி 12th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ் சப்ஜெக்ட், சாப்டர் 9. டைட்டில் இஸ் லிஸ்ட் டப்பிள் செட்ஸ் அண்ட் டிக்ஷனரி பார்ட் தி வீடியோ. வாங்க இப்போ வீடியோக்குள்ளே போகலாம். And this is, we are continuing with that lesson number 9, chapter number 9, list, tuples, sets and dictionary. Continuing with that list, the list comprehension. List is already explained about what is a thing means. List is a memory, like array. We have stored the many number of values, many type of value also in the same list. In the sequence, list comprehension means is a simplest way of creating sequential of elements but satisfy certain condition. The elements are in sequence, but that is how satisfy one condition based upon creating a list of values. Please think about one example. If you are creating the list, you are trying to store the statements, and the value is multiple of 10, right? Multiples of 10. And what is will be the value? First value is 10, next value is 100, next value is 1000, next value is 10,000. Like the values are multiples of tens. So the values are also in sequence. So we can create the list of values in a sequence of values and also satisfy the condition with any one of the condition. That is called list comprehension. Here there are given a syntax list expression for the variable in range. That means for loop. In this example, they are creating squares of numbers. That means squares as a list equal to X is one of the value, that means variable. Star star means it's a power. X star star 2 means X squared, like that. For X in range 1 to 11, that means up to 10, we are start with 1 X value and end with 10, lesser than 11. So what is the first one? 1 squared, first value. Then condition check, 1 will be going to be 2, 2 squared, and 3, 3 squared, 4 squared, 5 squared. That means up to 10 squared, value will be given, right? Values are in sequence, and also this will be satisfy one condition. And the other important functions are in the list, based upon the list. First one is copy. We can copy the list, that means list contents also. Directly we can copy the all the elements of the list, just copy paste like that. It's one of the function. It will be returns a copy of the list. Already have a list means we take one copy, like a Xerox copy, right? And the syntax is list.copy directly. That list means list name, mind it. And the example, my list is a list, list name equal to 12, 12, 36. That means three values are there,
And next, x equal to, that means a variable, my list is a list name, dot copy is the function name. Now, we try to print the x. See one thing, we are not printing my list. My list have three values. In x, we are copy the my list values. So, what is the values? Values are there in x. Just make a copy from the my list values. That means all the values in the my list value have are the same in the x also. So in print x means see the output, the same things, same thing of values, same number of values, same numbers also displayed. Our next function is count. And count means count the number of list elements in the list. Right? Similar elements present in the last. List dot count of values. We can directly give the values inside the count function. And see the example, my list equal to have some values, three values, and x equal to my list dot count of 12. Just we can take one value, right? And print x, the output is 2. And we are only given the value is single value, 12. And how the output is 2, number of elements, that means 12 is one of the value. And same kind of value is there in another value also. So count is returns the similar values on the list. If we are given 2 means only single 2 is there in the list means only output is 1. And 2 is there in multiple times, that means 5 times is there in the list means the output is 5. Right? This is the concept of this example. And index. What is the index value, position value? That means in this example, x equal to minus dot index of 12. That means first 12. That means 0, 1. The value is, the position is, the value's position is 1. First position is there. And reverse the order of the element in the list. Already there in one order means we can alter the order in the reverse. Just see the example 36, 23, 12 and minus dot reverse. Print minus means the 12 is last one, that will be first one here output. Because of reverse order, with that reverse function will be reversed the list. So 12, 23, 36. This is the order exchange. And short means the values, the directly the name is there, sort the element in the list. The syntax is list dot short, reverse equal to true or false, key equal to my function. So both the arguments are optional. We don't need to give in the this is not a compulsory one, these arguments, that means reverse and key. And ascending is default. If we are trying to sort the elements in the list means directly order the elements in ascending. And key equal to myfunc means the name of the user defined function that specifies the sorting criteria. If we are creating a new function, That function name we can give one. My function means short. Short is the function name. And will affect all the original list. It will be altered in the original sequence also. Not only for the temporary list. It's a permanently it will be altered the sequence. So in my list, have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 names are there. Tilotama, Dharani, Anita, Saisri, Lavanya. And here my list dot sort. Here we are trying to sort the list and print the element. And here my list dot sort reversed equal to true. So see the example my list dot sort. Right? On that location the names are sorted in the ascending order. So that will be print one time. That means print my list is there. So Anita, Lavanya, Sajri, it's a ascending order. Right? After that we are do the reverse option. My list dot sort reverse equal to true means. And that next also we are print the my list. So directly in reverse order. Tilotama T Dharani and yes in A option is going to be last one. So it's a reverse order, right? And max returns the maximum value in the list directly. If in my list we have 21, 76, 30, 98 and 23 means. What is the highest value? 28. Then print my max of my list. Directly we are using like this, the maximum values gets from the list. Minimum, same thing, opposite reaction. Minimum value, 21 is the minimum value that will be printed. And sum, add all the elements in the list. That's the meaning of sum. And see this example, div by 4 equal to nothing. That means that's a list empty. Right, there is no element, but we are creating for list for loop in range 21 and I divided by 4 and equal to 0. If we are trying to I value is divided by 4, the remainder value is going to be equal to 0 means D by 4 is append of I. That means we are gets 0 to 20 values. That means the range there is have 21 value. So that means 0 to 20. Right? So each and every one of the value in between of that range, and we will try to divide with the 4. Which are the divided? Completely divided with 4 means that will be add into the list. If your first value is 4, that means 0, 1, 0 is common, that will be printed. And 1, 1 divided by 4, remainder is not equal to 0. So that we are ignore. And next 2, that is also remainder is not equal to 0. And 3, that is also not equal to 0. And 4 means, we are divided with 4 means, equal to 1 time we can divide and remainder value is equal to 0. So that will be added to the list. After that 4 means 8. 8 divided by 4 means 2 time we can divide and equal to 0. Remainder is 0. So that will be added. Like, which are the values are can divide with the 4, the remainder is equal to 0, those values can add to the list and that will be displayed on the screen. And this is one of the example for the list. So here we are have some examples, other examples also we can see on the class. And this is the end of the list, and the continuation of this lesson is going to be the next video.
And this is the end of this video from MR Academy. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel. If you have any doubt about this chapter, please comment in the comment box. And please share this video to the others. If you are searching the jobs, please send your resume to my descriptive email ID. Thank you very much. We will see you again for this continuation of this lesson on next video. part 4. And thank you. Nandri, Vanakkam by MR Academy.